Hello and welcome to this tutorial video where I show you how to share your iCloud subscription and storage with your family members. So first things first, open up the Settings app on your iOS device. Here we are on the Settings main page. And you'll see your name with your Apple ID and information at the very top. If you haven't set up your family yet, just tap into that. So tap into your account there. And then you'll see something there that says family sharing. If we tap into family sharing, you'll see you don't have anyone added. Myself, I have my two kids and my wife. If you want to add someone, there's going to be an option here that says invite others or add family or add member, or you can tap the blue addition symbol in the upper right hand corner with the profile image there. And this is going to allow you to create a new person. So you can either invite others by tapping the invite link here, or they're having, you know, suggestions at the top of people that you message a lot, or you can create a child account by tapping on that button there. So let's say we want to create a child account. We tap into that there. It then will take us to the option where we can basically go through the whole process of creating a new account, giving them an Apple ID associated with their iOS account, and you're good to go. So add all of your family members if you haven't already. But let's say you already have your family members here. How do we share the iCloud storage? First things first, you got to have a 200 gigabyte iCloud package or above. So what you would want to do is once we're here under our Apple ID, we can tap into iCloud here and just make sure that you actually have the account. So go here and you can go to manage your plan. If we tap into manage your plan, you can see I pay for the 2 terabyte, which is the $10 or $9.99 per month option. The total storage will be 4 terabytes. So as you can see here, these are my upgrade options. You can always upgrade if you need more or if your family's using more than what you initially thought. So make sure you have the 200 gigabyte package or higher. Now go back to the option here where we're at your Apple ID. You can see your information at the top and you're going to see family sharing. Go to family sharing once more. And then you'll see something here under your family that says subscriptions. You can see I have 5 shared subscriptions. I want to tap on that option there. And you can see I'm sharing my Apple Music, Apple TV Plus, all the things that I get with my Apple One subscription. But down below there, you'll see something that says available to share. If you're subscribed to iCloud Plus, the 200 gigabytes or above, you'll have that option. Tap into that there where it says available to share, and then you'll see a button that says share with family. Now, another way to do this would be to go to manage your subscriptions, and then once here, find that service and tap into it and share that. But what you want to do is you want to go to the iCloud Plus, go to right here, iCloud Plus, and then you'll have the option to share with family. Tap into share with family, and then it'll automatically send out a notification to all of your family members' devices and iOS accounts to accept this, and then you're good to go. Then you close out of this, and everything in your iCloud plan, whatever that plan is, will be able to be shared with all of your family members. So, as you can see, I can go back now to my family, and if I scroll down and go to my option here and go to family sharing, you can see now that there are under subscriptions, iCloud is now being shared. So under shared, iCloud Plus shared by me. And then if we tap into that there, you can actually see the amount of data that each individual person in your family is using. So here's me at the top. There's my wife and my two kids. And you're kind of seeing exactly what they're using. So for me, I have both of my daughters backing up their iPads. And then my wife obviously backing up her iPhone and Apple Watch and things like that. So it's plenty of space for the 2 terabytes, 10 bucks a month. You maybe even can manage doing the package less than that. If you have any questions, please put those in the comment section down below. If this helped you out, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.